give your interior a whole new ambience. Create a new look and a new feel for your home with curtains made your way, your desired curtains. Today, I have Nakato Christine, an expert in curtains, who is going to guide us on which curtains you should use where, what type of curtains you should use where, and the price of the curtains. Join me and we learn together.
Curtains are any draping that you can use to cover your window or your door.
Mm.
Yes.
So it means if I got my lasso, hang it around a space of a window or my door, it's a curtain already?
Definitely. Mm. It's a curtain for you.
Mm.
But it depends on what you want to bring out when you are getting your lasso. Because you might want to talk about your personality, beautify your room, give it some sort of a feel, or give it some sort of life. So if you use your lasso, yes, you're actually satisfying a need. That might be just a privacy. But then you can also decide to get a fabric. You go for something that is beautiful, or you go for a color that you actually like, and you just want to come back to your home and you're like, well, I'm feeling life, or I've gone back to a home, or beautify your room. You look at your furniture, and you're like, let me blend in something that is beautiful. Because a curtain actually gives your room so much life.
What are the types? Do we have types of curtains?
Yes, we do.
Do you mind sharing with us what those types are?
We have curtains that are eyelets.
Mm.
We have sheer curtains. We have blackout curtains. For sheer curtains, they are mostly recommended for sitting rooms and living rooms because those ones let in some sort of light.
What are sheer curtains?
Sheer curtains are made more from material that is translucent,
mm.
that allows light to come through, that allows so much air to come through the room. And remember, a living room is space where people are mostly at all times.
Mm.
You go to the bedroom, but mostly to sleep.
Mm.
That is why mostly we recommend blackout curtains for the bedrooms. But then we also recommend those colors that are soothing.
Mm.
For example, we have blue, we have green, we have pink. It is known to be soothing.
To me, to be lilac.
Uh-huh. And to be lilac, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Christine, okay, over time, we've seen people with offices. We get to know that a curtain is some object that is going to block like light or direct mm-hmm. sunlight from coming to you
mm-hmm.
or even give you that privacy in a specified mm-hmm. area.
Yes.
We have offices. We have kitchens. We have bathrooms. We have bedrooms. We have living rooms.
Yes.
Does it matter what the kind of curtain you're going to use in any of those spaces?
It actually matters a lot.
Mm-hmm.
For example, actually for offices, you've also forgotten to talk about blocking out distractions.
Yeah.
So for offices, you can go for curtains. We have office blinds. We call them office blinds. They have that bit of formality.
Mm.
They are not too much to take away someone's attention from the work they're actually doing.
Mm.
But then they also serve all those purposes that you've talked about.
Mm.
So for blinds, we have actually minimal and silent colors.
Mm.
People usually go for gray, they go for blue, and they go for white when it comes to offices.
Mm.
Then for kitchens, we are mostly looking at around the kitchen sink and the bathroom. Those places come with water. So we have what we call waterproof curtains for such spaces, in that when you're washing or you're doing your dishes, you're not worried about making the curtain dirty or making the curtain wet. It is there, it serves its purpose. It will block out the light, or it will be opaque,
mm.
but then it's also making your kitchen look beautiful
mm.
and look nice. It's the same thing with bathrooms that are usually joined together with the toilets. You can actually be two people using the same space just because the other one is divided by a curtain
mm.
that is waterproof, and then you also have your space this other side.
Mm.
Yes.
Let's talk about the classifications of curtains.
Mm.
Because I entered in here and I saw different types of curtains.
Yes.
How do you classify them?
So a classifications when it comes to our market is more personalized. We look at the purpose. Mostly people look at the purpose. They look at the individual the curtain is going to serve. For example, here where we're seated, we're literally looking at the baby curtains.
Mm.
That's a classification. You're looking at a child who is going to come and enjoy their room and enjoy bedtime actually, and not fight about going to bed because you've picked out one of their favorite character and placed it in the room where they are going to sleep. Then we'll have the blackout curtains, usually for the bedrooms. So for the purpose of the blackout is someone is looking at, if I draw my curtain, I've actually closed off and I'm going to rest and my mind psychologically is going to rest. I'm not allowing any light to come through. For the sitting room, they usually come in very many patterns. You can go minimal, you can go bold.
When you mention minimal, what do you mean? Because now that's exactly what I want every viewer there to understand.
Okay. When I mention minimal, I'm talking about someone who wants something simple. For example, you can have cream walls, but then you also want a simple curtain. You also go for maybe like a deeper cream. That means you're just going minimal. For people who want bold, they'll have their cream walls, but they'll come and pick out a curtain that
like
has
red.
Character. Even a curtain that has character.
Because it's true.
Yes, we have such curtains. We have those big flowers, big beautiful flowers. We have curtains that have forest characters. They place you in a totally different environment.
True.
Yes.
So you want to tell me that a curtain has a different role of taking you from a different moment to another.
Yes, the curtain definitely does that.
Mm.
Yes, it depends on how you want your room to come out and to look.
Mm.
Which kind of feel are you trying to achieve when you're going for a curtain? Because we have had clients who come and they're like, my walls are either gray, so I just want a curtain to blend into my walls. I want something minimalistic, all simple. And then we've had clients who are like, my curtains, I want my curtains to be seen first before the rest of the furniture.
Mm.
So those are the ones that usually go for the bold patterns because they want you to walk into their room and you see the curtains first.
Mm.
Yes. And then the rest of the furniture silent.
You mentioned of the furniture.
Yes.
Curtains, furniture, everything that's interior designing.
Uh-huh.
And very many people have, let me say, messed up. You enter a room and you feel like you're suffocated. You're not, there's no that comfort. There's no that cool ambience. How can I use the curtains to create an atmosphere that is soothing?
One of the advice that they usually give us, you get your colors.
Mm.
Because you can just decide to have one concept. For example, I like maroon.
Mm.
It's really my color. So I necessarily, I do not have to say that my curtains are maroon and my chairs are maroon. Maroon has different shades. So you can have a color that is lighter and then you can also have a color that is darker. For curtains, curtains will add in the life because you can, if you have just the chairs and the table, the room is kind of silent. But then you go a step ahead and decorate the window and you also decorate the door. Yes, so curtains are like a window and door decor.
I agree with you.
Yes.
Not only window, but I think for the whole room, wherever they're going to be placed.
Yes, definitely.
Now, I see different fabrics. Which one goes where? Which one is recommended where?
Okay. For example, I talked about someone having wanting something minimal.
Mm.
And one or someone wanting their curtains to speak. So that is where you start making recommendations of if at all my furniture looks like this, all my wall looks like this, but still I want it to be minimal and plain yet beautiful at the same time. That is when you go for such colors. For bedrooms, the colors that I recommend personally, I recommend the soothing colors that I talked about. Blue actually is known to help with insomnia in case you're really struggling to sleep. You're struggling to sleep, you've had a very stressful day, you go for your blue. The beauty about it, all the colors are there, but then a blue will come fit for the sitting room when it is translucent and light, and then it will also have its forms where it's a blackout. Yeah, so you can still go for that blue. There is the turquoise blue. It's really beautiful. Personally, it is a color that I recommend for the bedroom.
When you mention the blackouts,
yes,
someone may not understand. What are the blackouts that you recommend and why?
So now the blackouts are, I would call it a material that doesn't allow light through, in simple terms. You'll have your security lights, but you'll still have your curtains. And don't worry about switching on the security light for security purposes and then not sleeping at night, because the two can just be so disturbing. There are those people who want to actually switch off. You've gone to bed, the light is off, and then you've drawn your curtain and you want it to actually look like it is night. You're trying to sleep, but then the security light is coming through. So you have to debate whether to switch it off or leave it on, and then you'll still stay awake because you're worried, well, I've left the security light off, now the thieves are going to come. So blackout is a material. Are those materials that do not allow light to come through.
Now, the blackouts are recommended for the bedroom.
Yes.
How is it with the living room?
So with the living room, still it comes back to someone's all to the customer's tastes and preferences. The blackout materials are really beautiful. You can't say that you won't recommend them for the living room because they are really beautiful. But for the living room, since no one is there overnight, the light can still come through. At the living room, you usually go for lighter shades, for the florals, the beautiful flowers. Then you have the impressions of the forests, depending on what the customer wants. Plain versus the bold moves. Yes. So, but still, for the living room, you can still do blackout. Yeah, the beautiful materials, because during the day, that is when you draw the curtain.
Yeah, during the day you draw the curtains because you want the light.
You want the light.
And you want the fresh air.
Yes, to come through, definitely. Yes.
So you can use those ones. But I may also need that. Not I may, but I want that fresh air also in my bedroom. That I want the same fresh air in my kitchen and my bathroom.
Yes. Now that is where the magic of curtain nets comes in.
The nets.
Yes, the curtain nets. Because it's a combination of actually both curtains and nets. The curtain nets come in different combinations. So that means if you have a blackout curtain for the bedroom, you'll also have a net. During day, you draw your curtains, you hold them, you let your net do the rest of the work for you. It will still maintain the privacy, but then you'll have light coming through, and then fresh air coming through the bedroom as well. And then it's the same thing with the kitchen, actually. You can draw the curtain and have the kitchen net.
Must I have a curtain at the same time a net?
No. No. There are cases where you can actually just have the net. Or for example, we usually have a living room connected to the dining room, but we usually have that section that does the divide. There you can just have a net. Or to let the room stay big, so that the space looks like it is not divided at any one moment. Yes, so you can have a net, just the net, and then you can also have just the curtain.
You can choose to have either or.
Yes.
So why is it that everywhere I'm seeing a net attached to a curtain?
Okay, by the way, there are cases. I think you've not yet gone through. Second floor actually has spaces that only have curtains. Yes, just curtains to let you know that, well, you can just decide to have only the curtain. As I told you earlier, the curtain serves very many purposes. You might find when one just wants a curtain just for privacy. Those are people who are okay to actually even do a lesso. You'll just come and just have the curtain. Then there are those ones who want to beautify the room, give it personality, give it its own like a language. So now you can go for a curtain, combine it with a net.
Let's talk about the lighting. How does the lighting, the painting, the furniture and curtains blend or marry?
So for all of those ones, most times when customers walk in here, all the advice that I would give them, you can have all those things in a room and they actually look cluttered, disconnected, all disoriented. So that is why when you're actually choosing your curtains for purposes of giving the room life, you need to put all of the items that are in the room already a consideration. The curtains should be able to communicate to the chairs, to the carpet you've chosen, to the table that you have in your room. They should be able to speak the same language. It's like a jungle. When you have the trees, they are green. Yeah. The grass is also green, and somehow, somewhere, the animals, all a particular snake, actually blends into that jungle. So the room has to be able to speak one particular language.
But you see, when you talk of the jungle, you cannot have green throughout, because yes. I don't want to imagine having green walls, green rug, then maybe the centerpiece is green. Then the couch is green. Hello. Yeah. What is that going to be?
That is a lot. Of course, that is a lot. The recommendation is usually still on someone's preferences. In case you want the same, maybe the same color, if per se your walls are gray and you want to still have gray curtains, what we recommend, you should have a shade darker and a shade lighter. It is either the wall or the curtain. One has to be darker and one has to be lighter. So actually that is the same concept you can apply on your furniture. But then we have colors that we categorize as neutral. For example, white, for example, cream, for example, even black. I would say that it is neutral.
Yeah, it is.
I like colors that go with any other color. Per se, if you have cream walls, that means you can have green curtains, you can have purple, you can have floral.
Even red.
Red. You can have literally any other color, if at all you have neutral colors. Then if you have colors that do not fall into the neutral bracket, that is when you just get that particular color and play around with its shades. Have one lighter versus one darker.
I want to talk about the size. Do we have standard sizes for these curtains?
We actually do not. That is the beauty about interior design. Whatever you have, first we can deliver. Because what we do, we actually go back and take your measurements. Because houses are made, but they are built differently. There are people who want...
Most architects actually also follow some standard sizes of windows, let me say, or doors. So it cannot fall far away from.
Yes. Still, they are standard sizes, but
for the curtains.
Yes, but it's like some sort of bracket. You might say if it is between 2 to 2.5 in width, maybe you can categorize that house as the window as small. Then 3 to 3.5 in width, you categorize the window as big.
Let's look. We talked of the length. Do we have a standard size for the length, or it's just a width that you can actually know that someone has called and we can give you a 1.5 or a meter is this much. So do you have a standard size of the length or the curtains?
The length, I would say still, it's the same concept that applies. We have a standard size and then we also do not have a standard size. Yes. We'll have a standard size of per se 2.5. Most houses fall within that bracket. But then we've also got houses where you run up to 3, up to 3.5, up to 4. Yes, but still, all those customers are catered for. Each and every person can get a curtain. Yes.
Then now, I'm putting the size aside. We have had issues. I have seen people assembling these curtains differently, hanging them differently.
Okay.
What is the ideal way of having a curtain hung up properly?
The ideal way is to have the a front side facing the room, because that is where all the character is.
The front?
Yes, facing inside the room. In that when you walk into your room, you can actually see your curtain design in case they are flowers. And the back side is usually facing the wall.
Now, in that case, we are talking of a one-faced curtain. Because, yes. I mean, some curtains are two-faced, whereby either or, you can't tell that this is the front or this is the back.
Yes.
So in an event where it's a one fest.
For a one fest, it actually doesn't have the same problem. Mm. Either way, but still, when they are making the curtain for you, they'll give you a hanging mechanism. Mm. The hanging mechanism will actually be able to dictate, yes, and guide that this is the front and this is the back. In case they are doing eyelets, still the hanging mechanism will dictate.
Because now you've mentioned of the hanging mechanism.
Yes.
Now also that one is a problem. People don't know which houses or which mechanism they should use.
Okay.
For instance, you mentioned of the
eyelets.
The eyelets.
Yes.
But apart from the eyelets, we have another one which has hooks.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So can you take us briefly on the hanging mechanism of curtains?
You can have your house, but then you do not understand it. Eyelets run with curtain rods.
Yeah.
Yes. Gypsum ceilings, that of course will automatically recommend gypsum rails. Mm. We also have aluminium rails. Mm. So those are all mechanisms of hanging the curtains. Mm.
We get tired. You're seated in a room, wind is blowing, the curtains are all flying, yes, covering your face, and maybe messing up things, because the more it blows, it can knock maybe a TV stand or anything, and then accidents. So yes, what's up with
such a case? It can simply be solved with a tie box.
Okay, you have,
yes,
tie box.
Yes, we have tie box, and they also come in different types, different designs. It's a variety. And for example, in case you have children who are young, who are prone to picking things and then losing them, we'll recommend wall tie backs.
Mm.
We come and screw it onto the wall. When you are drawing back the curtains, you just draw back the curtain and put it in the tie back. The tie back will hold it. And when you're drawing back, you just remove it and draw it back.
Mm.
In case you don't have anyone who will lose your tie back, we recommend there are those other beautiful ones.
Which one?
The way it is called the tie back, it is like in form of a rope.
Mm.
You're going to tie the curtain. That is where the word actually comes from. You tie the curtain back to draw in light or to let in fresh air.
Mm.
Yes.
Heard it all from the horse's mouth. You cannot say that Homes and Construction is not doing you well. We are here, we pledge to always get you the best on the market, to always get you the best information which you need, because these are the questions you continue asking us. So we have learned that you can have what you want. You want that fancy look, you want that ambience, you want to change a look, the look of your home. You can have your curtains made to your desire. This is the Homes and Construction Show. From me and my entire crew, we say thank you very much for staying with us from where we started from until now. And in our next episode, wait, we are bringing you some other beautiful, beautiful things. My name is Hilda Kamkamba.